Today we're going to talk about Workbook 4A, Exercise 7. This is in the textbook on page 17. We're going to use the skills that we have learned when we started talking about rounding, and we'll actually do some math with it to find an estimation. Sometimes in math, many times in math, most of the time in math, we want to have an exact answer. If we say 712 plus 492, we want to get the exact number of that problem and say that that is 1,204. But sometimes we want to round and estimate. So let's see what happens if you round and estimate. Now it's important to know how you're going to round. In this case, it gives you the instructions that you're going to round to the nearest hundred. So 712 rounds to 700, 492 rounds to 500, and when you add 700 and 500, we have 1200. The value is about 1200. Now the word about is important. The value is exactly 1204, but the value is about 1200. Please notice we don't find the answer and then round the answer. We're going to round each value and then add them together. So then we have some practice, and again the instructions are round each number to the nearest hundred and then find the value of the addition or subtraction problem. So again, thinking in terms of place value, this is 384, which rounds to 400, 296 rounds to 300. So when I estimate this, I say it's about 700. 507 will round to 500. 892 will round to be 900. And when I add them, it is an estimate of 1,400, or if you prefer, 1,400. 914 on letter C rounds to be 900. 707 rounds to be 700. When I combine them, the estimate for the sum of the numbers is 1,600. Estimation is good when you don't have to have exactly the number, you just want to know around how much is it. And we actually do that a lot in the real world. When we're doing math problems, we usually want an exact number. But if you're going to feed people and you need to know how many mashed potatoes to make, you just need to know about how many people you're going to feed, not necessarily to the nearest mouthful. Now we're going to do some practice doing the same thing with subtraction. Works out the same. 716 rounds to 700. 382 rounds to 400. When I subtract, I find that it's approximately 300. 700 minus 400 is 300. Letter E, 983 rounds to 1000. Subtract, 296 rounds to 300. 1000 minus 300 is pretty close to 700. Well, 1000 minus 300 is exactly 700, but that means that the estimate of 983 subtract 296 is 700. Last one on this page, 1408 rounds to 1400, 693 rounds to 700, and 1400 minus 700 is equal to 700. So that's the estimate for that subtraction problem. Continuing on page 17, now we're going to do the same thing with three numbers instead of two. It's just more practice, it's more difficult practice. By now, when you look at these, can you look at it and see that this would round to 800 minus 300 plus 500? I think it's always good with math to stop and think. If I do 800 minus 300, I have 500. And then if I add 500, I get 1,000. Notice if I combine the two numbers that I'm going to add together, 800 plus 500 is 1,300. And if I subtract 300, I get 1,000. It's good to notice that as long as I can combine both of the numbers I'm adding together and then subtract one time at the end, or I can do left to right and say 800 minus 300 is 500, add 500 is 1,000. That's just a free little nice fact about math. But the estimation of those values is 1,000. Is it exactly 1,000? No, but it's close. So let's practice these. Again, I would encourage you to pause the recording, work it on your own, turn it back on and check your work. 418 rounds to 400, 293 rounds to 200, 108 rounds to 100. When I add these together, 400 and 300 and 100 is about the same thing as 700. By the way, in your workbook, it tells you each time round to the nearest hundred. In this, it actually just says estimate the value, but if you look at the little person with the thought bubble, it does tell you that you're rounding each number to the nearest hundred. You could, of course, round this number to the nearest 10, but that would be more difficult if you're going to add them together. The estimation would be closer to the actual value if you round to the nearest 10, but we're just rounding to the nearest 100 because that little guy with his thought bubble suggested it. 784 rounds to 800, 617 rounds to 600, 399 rounds to 400. So if I add these together, I notice 600 and 400 make 1,000. So I'm going to say this is about the same thing as 1,800. Letter C. Always be careful to read the problem correctly. 814 rounds to 800, 208 rounds to 200. I'm going to subtract. That's what you have to notice in C. There's a subtraction. 587 rounds to 600. 800 and 200 is 1,000. 1,000 minus 600 is 400. So the best estimation of this answer is 400. Letter D, I have 1,205, which rounds to 1,200, 489, which rounds to 500, 596, which rounds to 600, and notice I'm subtracting 500 and subtracting 600. Again, I think this is fascinating. If I take 1,200 minus 500, I find that to be 700, and 700 minus 600 gives me an estimate of 100. But just for fun, I'd like you to notice this. I'm going to subtract 500 and then I'm going to subtract 600. Altogether, I'm going to subtract 1,100, and 1,200 subtract 1,100 is in fact the same answer because I can combine the ones I'm going to subtract and subtract them all at once, and that works out just fine. It's a nice way to think about math as well. Okay, after all of that, you're ready to practice on exercise 7.